guys are in for a great show. You sit back, relax, leave the entertaining to us. We're set, we've been trained for a long time just to perform for you today. Just a few moments, you're going to see our opening act coming in, and you'll be pleasantly surprised, because there's nothing more exciting than what you're about to see. Coming in from the right, at speeds over 45 miles per hour, the Minnesco Barefoot Line! We've got a great show lined up for you today. The Harlem Globetrotters are with us. We've got the American Gladiators. The musical guests, the Village People. We've also got country singer Lori Morgan. And now I'd like to bring out our first act, straight from Wauwatosa, Wisconsin, the Wauwatosa West High School Varsity Chess Team.
Wait a minute, there's no applause. Jane, that's boring. Big surprise.
I think we'll cut that act. We need something that's really going to get these people excited. You got any ideas? The National Association of Taxidermists. I don't think so. How would you guys like to see some beautiful women? Well, without any further delay, here they are, straight from New York City, the Rockettes.
No.
late night welcome to the Village People.
These guys are the kings of rock.
Glad you liked it. Get off my stage.
Because everybody's used spoons and beaver on a corpse.
Well, now, up next on Late Night with Maniasco, we got a Red Door segment. You guys ever heard of stupid human tricks? Well, we got some of those for you. Starting off, right behind that gate, we're going to do a backwater barefoot. Now, this guy's going to start off skiing backwards. That's pretty stupid. Or we're going to take it a step higher. That boat's going to accelerate him to 35 miles per hour. Now, that's even dumber. We want to top it all off with him stepping right off that ski. And he's going to continue grinding, pounding, and beating against that water on nothing but the sole of his bare feet. Ladies and gentlemen, what could possibly be dumber than this? In just a few moments, our Mastercraft, powered by its 351 Corvette engine, is going to pull right out behind that big, blue, beautiful Miniesca curtain with our skier. And we'll see our first stupid human trick of the afternoon. I love having this segment on the show. In fact, we might even have several stupid human tricks. So now, coming in from the left, let's hear it. And he steps right off that ski and continues on nothing but the sole of his bare feet. Well, guys, that was dumb, but I think we can increase the level of stupidity a little further. If you'll look down to the left side of the beach, you'll see our next two victims, excuse me, performers, about to perform their stupid human trick. Give a wave, Ron and Chris. They're going to lay down on their backs. And then our inboard Mastercraft is going to whip them right off the beach, holding their bungee cords, bouncing, beating, pounding, until they're standing up on nothing but the sole of their bare feet. Ladies and gentlemen, a beach start barefoot. Well, these tricks are getting better and better. You guys want to see another one? All right, you're in luck, because we've got another for you. This time, we're going to do a deep water start. And you'll look over to the starting dock. In just a moment, you'll see our next stuntman, Harry Devitt, coming in from the right side in a back deep water start. Pulling, beating, pounding on his face until he stands up on the soles of his bare feet. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Harry Devitt. Something even dumber. I think we can top that. In fact, I'm sure of it. My producer set up this next stunt to be so incredible, no one's ever seen it before. Coming in from the left, our two ski jump outs, and they're going to continue on their bare feet, ladies and gentlemen. Well, I like this trick idea we've been having, but we're out of stupid human tricks. What could we possibly do next? Some trick skiing, and up to do that, we have our very own American Gladiators. Over there on the dock, ladies and gentlemen, our first three gladiators, John, and up on the blocks, Lori and Sue. Our first gladiator preparing, Mr. John Mormon, is about to perform a deep water, backwards, toe-hold stunt. He'll be pulling, grinding, performing a literal tug-of-war with that hydromet. Just one man against a twin 200 horsepower Yamaha engine. Let's hear it, ladies and gentlemen, for John Mormon's backwater, toe-hold stunt. Look over the dock, you can see our trick skiing sisters, Lori and Susie, depart for their battle with the Master Craft. You know, I had a chance to talk with all the gladiators before the show, and I asked them what they were going to do. Well, they like surprises, but they're going to battle performing 360, 180, helicopter spin, and maybe even a 540. Welcome, coming in from the right, our first gladiator, battling it out with that Eiderdyne, Mr. John to right. We've got, in perfect synchronization, our trick skiing sisters, Lori and Susie, performing toe turns. Well, we've got quite a battle going on here on Late Night with Miniatka, but it's not over yet. In just a moment, John Lorman's going to be coming in front of us one more time. Let's see what battle techniques he's got for us. Coming in from the left, ladies and gentlemen, fighting it out once again with that Heiderdine, performing a helicopter, Mr. John Lorman.
second look to the far right. You'll see our first rope climber dribbling in up to that jump. He wants to get some serious air. He's coming in to perform a front flip. Mr. Eric Pax. He's got his heart count, his training, his dedication. He's all set. Approaching that jump. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Eric Pax. Going for the jump at a time. That's always impressive. But let's add another spear to this. As you see our mastercraft come right by that starting dot, they're going to pick up Scott DeBoer. But they're not going to stop. Scott's got to grab his rope out there, and he's going to be whipped off. But Greg's not even going to slow down. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for the hot pickup. But wait a minute. Those two spears, that free rope. They only need one of these. But wait, here comes Eric without a rope to grab the third one. And we're going to see all three of our Harlem Globetrotters attack that jump together. In just a moment, our mastercraft is going to whip them around. All three of those spears are going to hit that jump and perform for you a triple helicopter. Now, each of those spears are wearing skis that are 6 feet in length. Our jump is 14 feet wide. That means we're gonna have 18 feet of skis on a jump that's 14 feet wide. So this takes a tremendous amount of skill and dexterity so that all three jumpers can perform this in perfect synchronization. If you look out to the right, you'll see skiing in our first three Globetrotters about to perform the triple helicopter. They're together, bouncing. Water, eyeing that jump. They're going to show that jump just who's boss. Ladies and gentlemen, our Harlem Globetrotters perform a triple. But our Globetrotters aren't done jumping yet. They've got another one they want to do. They're going to grab that one guy, pull him out of the water, and they're going to jump again. But what do they want to do this time? I know they love doing those helicopters. So we'll have two of them do helicopters. But one of them's kind of a rebel and doesn't want to do that again. So two of our Globetrotters will perform helicopters once again. But one of them's going to do a front flip instead. As our master craft pulls them right out of the water. Whips them back around so they can attack that jump one more time. The two jumpers on the outside will perform the helicopters. And the one in the center will perform the front flip. Now this jump takes a tremendous amount of coordination. All of the skiers have got to time their moments just right. If they don't do it, can't you guys hold on to these? Why don't you keep those basketballs bouncing around so we get all the more adrenaline into the Harlem Globetrotters. Our mastercraft's going to whip them around. They can't wait to perform this next jump. They've been telling me about it for weeks now. They've practiced. They've perfected it. In fact, I don't know anyone that can do it better than three of these guys. Wait till, ladies and gentlemen, the Harlem Globetrotters are about to perform their fourth jump. Once they get enough water between them and the jump, our fourth mastercraft. Behind the wheel, we have our five-year veteran, Jammin' John Schleicher. Going to whip them around, approaching that jump. Once they accelerate the speed of over 35 miles per hour, they'll be ready. They'll be set. They'll be prepared to take that jump. Even though our jump's only 5 feet high, those skiers will probably get up 8 or 9 feet above the water and land, all in synchronization. If they time their movements just right, they'll then perform the perfect jump. Now you can see them coming in to the right. Our three Harlem Globetrotters preparing to attack that jump. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for the front flip and two helicopters. All right, ladies and gentlemen. In just a few moments, our Harlem Globetrotters will be coming in, and I'll introduce them to you. Jumping acts. We need a tremendously skilled boat driver. How about a hand for our 5-year veteran, Jammin' John
like her.
And now why don't y'all say hello to our jumper, the Harlem Globetrotters. Ladies and gentlemen, from right to left, Eric, Ray, and Scott. Is about to perform something that's next to impossible. Ladies and gentlemen, may I present the Minnesota Acrobats performing a prefabricated pyramid. They've got to successfully build one of these pyramids first to the dock and then move it onto the shore. A three-tier prefabricated human pyramid, ladies and gentlemen. Pyramids on the water, so imagine the strength, skill, and dexterity it takes to successfully build one on the pier and then move it onto the water all the time, keeping it in perfect formation. In just a few moments, our Hydrodyne is going to pull in our Minnesota acrobats, and I'll be able to introduce them to you. They're pretty incredible. They've worked for hours on end, practicing balance, strength, and dexterity. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for the Minnesota acrobats, the builders of our three-tier. Ladies and gentlemen, Lisa and Harry, Michelle and Chris, and on the far side, Ann and Matt. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it one more time for the Minnesota acrobats. Thanks, guys. You know, to tell you the truth, I love performing for you like this, but it wears on you. Your voice gets beat up. So I think I'm going to surrender the mic. Who should I give it to? I've got so many guests. Ladies and gentlemen, it's Miss Lori Morgan. How you doing today, Lori? I understand that you've got some new backup singers you're working with. Ski-Haw Girls. Where'd you pick them up? They just float in and kind of work with you, huh?
They're talking to the YMCA people.
Really, are they leaving your backup singers alone backstage? Well, why don't I hit it? Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Lori Morgan. And ladies and gentlemen, her backup singers, the Ski-Haws.
Thank you.
backup singers. Lori, Susie, and Jenny. And now, skiing in from the right, we have our second group of backup singers. Jessica, Kristen, and Lisa. This as much as probably all of you do. Commercials. But producers, executives, networks, all those people say that we've still got to do them. So please bear with me for this next one. Ladies and gentlemen, our new sponsor, Snapwell Cookies.
Say hello to Aaron, Chris, and Mike. And right behind them, their beautiful Adagio Park.
Oh, wait a minute.
gentlemen, in just a few moments, we're welcoming back our first Adagio couple. Please give a loud and warm late night welcome to Shonda and Eric. And now, standing in from the right, we are our next Adagio couple. Please say hello to Michelle and Prince. Tonight's first top 10 list. Tonight we're going over the top 10 things you hear while at the state tournament. Number 10, Gainesville won again. Number 9, is butt floss the technical term for those costumes? Number 8, I knew we should not have held our team meeting in the beer tent. Number 7, these seats are same. Number 6, Whitewater's next. You want to go eat? Number 5, are those real? Number 4, I could have skied pro this summer. Number 3, she had a boyfriend? Number 2, no it doesn't. Number 2, and that's my girlfriend I'm talking about. Number 2, is that the 8th or 9th pyramid to show? And the number 1 thing you hear at the state tournament, I can do that. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we've seen some pretty incredible acts. And to tell you the truth, I'm a little confused as to what I should bring out next. I think I know. The people of Hawks Breath High School and their marching band. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the water our first marching unit from Hawks Breath High School. To our second group from Hawks Breath High School, about to leave for their performance on the lake. Now I get thousands of letters each week from young people wanting to come on Late Night with Vinnieska, but I never let them come on unless they do something really incredible, really special. And here now they come in from the right, behind our hide or die, our first unit from Hawks Breath High School.
Oh,
course through their choreography and their musical instrument playing. So once I got their letter, I knew that they were worthy candidates to be on Late Night with Benny Esco. In just a few moments, you'll see our first marching unit coming by again for their next pass. And now here they come, ladies and gentlemen, in from the left once again, our first Augsburg High School marching unit. Jennifer. And now please direct your attention to the right, coming in. Our second star swivel skier, about to perform a 720 degree turn. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, the Minnieska Acrobats. You saw these guys once before, and they built a perfect, three-tier, prefabricated human pyramid. Well, they like pyramids a lot. They want to do another one. But this time, they're going to build it in the water. Our Hydrodon is going to whip them right off that dock. And once they're out of the lake, they're going to begin themselves so that they can build for you a three-tier human pyramid while on the water. This takes a tremendous amount of skill, coordination, strength, and dexterity. Now, our Minnieska Acrobats can build a successful three-tier pyramid. They've got to time their moments just right. They've got to work together, practicing hours on land and hours on the water, so they can successfully do this for you today. If you look out to the water, you'll see the acrobats positioning themselves around, building that pyramid. They should have it perfect in just a few moments, and they'll see around in front of you. And we will have the 1995 Minnieska 3-tier pyramid. How about that, ladies and gentlemen? A perfect 3-tier human pyramid with a double top built on the water. Well, here, ladies and gentlemen, for the Minnieska Acrobats, as they come by with their perfect 3-tier human pyramid with a double top and two flankers. And now I'd like to take the time to acknowledge the people that have been helping me out all day. Over there, behind our big, blue, beautiful Minnieska curtain, making sure that you see no way before it's time. Our dock and equipment crew, Mickey and Joe. And over on sound, running the music, making sure I sound okay, and making sure our acts go smoothly, we have DJ Jazzy Jane. And in just a few moments, our Hydrodyne's going to whip in the rest of our Minnieska Acrobats that are on the water. And at that time, it'll be my pleasure to present to you the 1995 Minnieska Acrobats. Here they come, ladies and gentlemen, for the last time today, the Minnieska Acrobats. Human pyramid with its double top.
the Mini Extra Acrobats, and the rest of the 1995 Mini Extra Speed Team. Sure.